Welcome to the Mobile Money Nation. My name is AJ, and today I'm going to talk about GameStop, Wall Street Bets, Melvin Capital, and a very historic short squeeze. So over the past month, GameStop stock has had an epic increase. On the start of the year, or the start of the trading year at least, GameStop stock was only $19. Now, just 3 months before this, it was worth 100% less than it was to start the year. In fact, on October 8th, it rose from $9 to $13 in a single day. Even at that point, that was almost a 50% gain and a lot more than it was worth even a year ago. In fact, less than a year ago, it was under $3 per share. But over the month of January, it has risen from $19 to as high as over $500 per share. Now, over the past 20 years, the highest GameStop has ever been before this year was $60. So in just 20 years, the stock has never been over $60. However, in the past month, it is almost 10x its previous high in just 3 weeks. So why would GameStop, or any stock for that matter, rise so much in a short period of time? Now, sometimes companies, they increase in value because of some news of some product or some service, or maybe a huge influx of customers that are buying that specific company's product. But that's not the case for GameStop. As many of you may know, and if you don't, I'll tell you, in the recent past, GameStop has not been doing well as a business. Not only that, but even game makers like PlayStation and Xbox, they've gone more to digital downloads. So the PlayStation 5 that recently came out back in November, they actually have two versions. They have one version that does not come with a disc, and they have a disc version. So when the majority of your sales as a company come from game-related purchases, whether that's accessories, the actual games, or the gaming systems, and people don't have to come into your store to even buy new games, then that makes it very hard for your company to make money. And so because of that, there are hedge funds and individual investors who think that GameStop will go out of business at some point in the future. And when someone thinks that a company is going to go out of business in the future and they want to make money out of it, they will short sell the stock. And so what is a short sell? A short sell is when you're basically betting against a company. And in order to bet against them in the stock market, what you would need to do is sell stock at a higher price to someone and then buy that stock back once it gets to a lower price or whatever the price target that you set when you decided to short the stock. And so because you don't own the stock, you're actually selling something you don't own. In order to close your position or to get out of the trade, you are forced to buy it back at some point, and hopefully that point it has a lower price so that you can get the difference in what you sold it for compared to what you buy it back for. And so, for instance, if a stock was $1,000, you sold it for $1,000 because you thought it was worth less than $10. And then if it actually reaches the $10 or whatever the price target you have, you didn't buy it back for $10. And so the money that you would gain on that one share would be $1,000 minus 10, which would be $990 per share. And so if you were to do that with hundreds or thousands or potentially millions of shares, you could make billions of dollars short selling a company. And that is exactly what Melvin Capital, a hedge fund, has done. They have put an extreme bet against GameStop, expecting that it is more than likely going to go bankrupt, or at the very least, it's going to be worth less in the future than it was at the time that they put in their short sell. And so where does Wall Street Bets come in? Someone on Reddit posted in the subreddit Wall Street Bets that they found a company, that company being GameStop, that was being shorted over 130% of the shares available for purchase. Now, why is it even possible for someone to sell more shares than what's even available on the market? That's a question that's probably going to be talked about in Congress very, very soon. I can guarantee you that. But they saw that GameStop was being shorted, and at the time that I saw it, it was 138% short interest on GameStop. And so when something is highly shorted, if there's any news, especially any good news that would cause people to want to buy GameStop stock or any stock that is being shorted, if that stock were to rise in price, then anyone that is short selling the stock, if they think that this is going to be a long-term trend and that the stock is going to continue to rise higher, then it is in their best interest to now buy back the stock and get out of their short position. Why is that? When you buy a stock normally, most people buy and they go long. And that's when you're buying and you're expecting a stock to increase in value. When you buy a stock like a regular person would, there's an infinite amount of value that a company could potentially have. Theoretically speaking, a stock can go up infinitely. But when you're going long, when you're purchasing stock expecting it to go up, the most money that you can lose is whatever money you put into the stock. So if you buy a stock for $100, that company goes bankrupt, you only lose $100. But when you short sell, you're doing the exact opposite. You are selling a stock that you don't own, and you are trying to buy it back at a lower price. The problem is that now that infinite gain that you would have if you were going long is now on the opposite side. So if the stock actually does go up infinitely in price, then you could potentially have infinite losses if you continue your position as a short seller. And so that is what is called a short squeeze. A short squeeze is when a company who is short selling a stock is forced to buy back the stock at a higher price than what they initially expected when they put in their short position. And this is what someone found out on Wall Street Bets when they saw that GameStop was being shorted at over 138% short interest. But not only that, there's a thing called a short ratio. And now what a short ratio is the amount of short interest on a specific stock divided by the average trading volume of that particular company. So on any given day, a particular stock could be traded, it could be bought and sold, thousands or millions or potentially even billions of different transactions in a single day. At the time that I look at GameStop stock, the short ratio was 28. That means that based on the average volume of people who buy and sell GameStop stock, it will take 28 days of the market being open and having that same average volume of trading in order for all short sellers to close their position by buying more stock. Now, while that short ratio has now dropped to about 2 days, the short interest is still over 100%. It is actually around 120% based on my source, which I used, finviz.com. You can view the short interest of any stock on their website, as well as the short ratio. But according to them, based on their last update at the timing of this recording, the short interest was still over 120%, but the short ratio, due to the increased volume of more people buying and or selling GameStop stock, mostly buying, that short ratio is now down to 2. Now, one of the things that happens with, in a case like this, when a stock is increasing so much in such a short amount of time, is that more people come in to buy the stock. Some people are coming in because they're basically gambling. They see an opportunity to make money, and it's going up really fast, and they want to try to take advantage of the momentum at the moment. Now, there are some people who are investing based on what they saw on Wall Street Bets on the Reddit forum. Some people are investing only because they see that the stock is increasing significantly in a short amount of time. But it creates a frenzy that is very similar to the lottery. Now, if you've ever seen the lottery, where whenever the lottery gets to a significantly high amount, let's say multi-hundreds of millions of dollars, then people that don't even normally play the lottery, they start to play the lottery too. They see that, oh, I have a chance to win, let's say $200 million or $500 million, and so I'm willing to waste $1 or $20 or even $100 on lottery tickets, even though on a regular basis, they would not play the lottery. And so this same type of enthusiasm is happening with the GameStop stock. Now, the only difference is that with this enthusiasm, with the lottery, when you put money in, you lose it. You don't have to worry about selling anything. You don't have to worry about buying anything back. You put in your money. If you don't win, you lose all of your money. But because this is not a lottery and this is the stock market, there's always someone on the other end of the trade. There's always a buyer and there's always a seller. And in this case, there's very large short interest on this stock, forcing more people to buy it. Not because they want to and they're going to make money by it, but the short sellers have to actually buy the stock in order to prevent themselves from losing more money. And so it's kind of a triple threat where you have someone who saw an opportunity for a short squeeze. You have other people that are coming in just because they see that a stock is rising and they want to try to make money themselves. And then you have the short seller who also has to buy in order to prevent themselves from losing money. And so that creates a squeeze and causes the stock to increase even higher, even though the fundamentals or the actual value of GameStop as a company has not changed over the past month. And so who is winning this lottery, or this lottery that's happening in the stock market at the moment? Anyone that is buying GameStop stock at this moment. Anyone that either followed Wall Street Bets, or maybe they received a text or a friend or a coworker told them about it, because once something crazy like this is happening, it's going to be in the news. They're going to talk about it on CNBC. People are going to be texting each other like, hey, do you own GameStop? Are you going to buy GameStop? That's going to happen. And with people making so much money with a stock going from $19 to begin the year to now, before the market opened, over $500 per share, there's a lot of money that a company could lose if they are still short selling, or may have already lost if they waited too long to buy back their position. But who stands to lose? This is where we go back to Melvin Capital, the hedge fund that has the largest short position of this stock. Now, Melvin Capital is a well-known hedge fund. They're well known for short selling and being successful at short selling. And so when a company is well known and they're well known for being successful, other people follow them as well. And hedge funds and large investors, every quarter they have to announce what they buy and sell. They have to report that to the SEC, and it is publicly available for anyone to see. And that's how the people who posted this on Wall Street Bets were able to know that the stock was being shorted heavily by this one particular hedge fund, but also using free websites like Finviz, or maybe even paid websites like Zacks. You can look at the short interest and the short ratio of pretty much any stock. And so due to this very historic increase in value of this one particular company, and there are other companies as well, not just GameStop, companies like Nokia, BlackBerry, other companies that are being targeted by people on Wall Street Bets, but also being shorted by companies like Melvin Capital. And you can actually see what they're short selling on the SEC website. Or you can at least see what they were short selling if they haven't already closed all their positions, because they only have to report once per quarter. And so Gabe Plotkin, who is the hedge fund manager or maybe the founder of Melvin Capital, he is in deep trouble at the moment and needed a huge cash infusion, and he was able to get $2.7 billion from two specific firms. Those firms are Citadel Securities and Point72, which is founded by the owner of the Mets, Stephen Cohen. Now, what gets really interesting is the relationship between these three people, as well as the brokerage firm Robinhood. Now, Robinhood is a free trading app. It is very popular amongst millennials or younger investors. They offer free trading. They were one of the first brokerage firms to offer this, and that's another reason it made it very popular for younger investors or people who don't invest a lot of money in the market. And so it is also one of the most popular or the most talked about brokerage firms on the Wall Street Bets subreddit. Now, for those who don't know, and I didn't know this before I did a little research, Gabe Plotkin used to work at Steve Cohen's old hedge fund, SAC Capital, and he worked for him for 8 years. Once he left SAC Capital, Stephen Cohen actually invested into Melvin Capital over $1 billion, as far as what I read in the articles that I've read. And so they're already linked because they have a prior relationship, as Stephen Cohen was the founder of SAC Capital. Gabe Plotkin worked for SAC Capital. And even after Gabe Plotkin left SAC Capital to work on his own and create Melvin Capital, Stephen Cohen invested into Melvin Capital. And so it's not a surprise that Stephen Cohen would now invest part of half or some percentage of that $2.7 billion that was loaned to Melvin Capital in order to save them based on this short sell squeeze that is happening at the moment. Now, where does Citadel Securities come in? Citadel Securities, the other half of the $2.7 billion that was loaned to Melvin Capital, they are what is known as a market maker. And so when brokerages are sending orders in order to be processed by people who are buying and selling, those are sent to market makers. Citadel Securities is one of those market makers. Citadel Securities is also the largest customer of the brokerage firm Robinhood. Now, they aren't the only market maker that Robinhood uses, but they are the company that they send the most orders to. And so with Robinhood sending their orders, many of them buy orders for GameStop at the moment, to Citadel Securities, a company who has now loaned money to Melvin Capital, who is losing a lot of money due to the buy orders from Robinhood, as well as other brokerages. People aren't only buying GameStop on Robinhood. People are buying it on TD Ameritrade, Interactive Brokers, Fidelity, E-Trade. Pretty much anywhere that they can buy it, they're making an attempt to buy it. It gets really interesting when Robinhood decides to not allow people to buy GameStop stock for a day. They are now going to limit the orders of GameStop, or at least the buy orders of GameStop on this Friday. And on Thursday, they only allowed you to close your orders, meaning you were only able to sell on Thursday if you already owned GameStop stock on Robinhood and on a few other brokerage accounts. And so the company that they're sending their orders to is loaning money to a company who is losing money based on those buy orders. And to add another interesting twist to this relationship, Stephen Cohen's former firm, SAC Capital, is a firm that paid $1.8 billion in fines because their company was investigated for insider trading. Now, while Stephen Cohen himself did not serve any time, the fund manager at that time was sentenced to 3 years in prison for his part in this insider trading that was caught by authorities. And so you can see why people aren't very happy with Robinhood. They're not happy with Melvin Capital or Citadel Securities. They see this as a conflict of interest, and to stop people from being able to buy, which would then cause Melvin Capital to lose even more money. And the company that's trying to save Melvin Capital by loaning them money is also receiving those orders ahead of time. And so to kind of know what Robinhood users are buying, that seems like a huge conflict of interest. And it's gonna be really interesting to see what plays out in the future. And what will happen in the future? Only time will tell. I personally believe that GameStop, their company, isn't really valued that much. They're definitely not worth $500 per share. The value of any individual company in the stock market is whatever someone else is willing to pay for it. And right now that is about $300 or $400. But as I mentioned, there's always someone else on the other end of the trade. In order for there to be a buyer, there has to be a seller. In order for there to be a seller, there has to be someone willing to buy. But in this case, with a short squeeze, sometimes the buyer is buying not because they want to, but because they need to stop losing money. So while there are people making thousands of dollars and millions of dollars buying GameStop, please be advised that sometimes you don't know why someone is buying or why someone is selling. Fortunately, in this case, at least the people who follow Wall Street Bets, you do know, at least you know what they posted as their reason for buying GameStop stock, and it has worked out very well for many of the people who followed this trade. So let me know what you think about this video. Let me know what you think about GameStop stock. Are you a buyer? Are you a seller? Are you willing to take this risk on your hard-earned money? And how much money have you risked or made based on this trade and this short squeeze, which is technically still going on? All right, thanks for watching this video. If you're not a current member of the Mobile Money Nation, all you need to do is hit the subscribe button down below, hit the like button because you really like this video, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Again, thanks for watching. Have a great day.